Hello, everyone. Very welcome you to our Life Online Tai Chi class again. We continue offer this online classes to promote Tai Chi and health wellness. Today, I will give an introduction of the Tai Chi Ba Fa Wu Bu and Yang Style Tai Chi 24 form. Then we will also do some gentle warm-up and some fundamental exercise. Then hope from this class, it will be benefit for all of you and get to know some fundamental Tai Chi form. And if you're interested to learning, continue, then you always can follow in for more classes in the future. All right. So we're always going to spend a few minutes to do some warm up. So please loosen your body. Just let me pump, relax all the joints through your body. So this is the warm up. Then take a deep breath. Refresh your body and mind. Feel opening and relaxing. One more time. Very simple, just follow me. Inhale. Exhale. Very good. Then we're also going to get all the joints from the shoulder and neck and the muscles on the back, hip, everywhere through your body to give some loosening, rotating. And move your neck very gentle. Then we also can rotate in our wrist, finger, also the elbow. Try to get rid of all the tense from our muscles through our body and joints. Okay, give some massage on your lower back. Then we're gonna gentle stretch, very slow. Don't go too down, take it easy. And try to relax your shoulder and muscles on the back. And open the step wider. Opening, feel your body very smooth. Okay, stretch a little bit more. Stretching your leg and feel relaxing, opening from your hips. Very nice. Then we'll also need to massage. Give some massage, very gentle on the knees. Just try to straight and bend. Feel your knees. And slowly come up. All right, then we will stretch our Achilles and the ankle. Gentle bouncing down. And feel your spine open, body upright, opening and lifting from top and pressing down. Feel your feet getting grounded. Nice. And try both sides. Again, very gentle. Give some gentle stretch on the Achilles, also the ankle area. Okay, so we can relax and rotating. Your ankle. You also can put your foot on your on the floor if you can't stand on one leg, or you can hold on something. Okay, both sides. All right, shake it out. Let's see if anywhere you feel not completely warmed up, please do. And then we will get ready for the Tai Chi practice. One more time, deep breathe through your nose, rising up and going down. Washing through your body. Okay, we know when we practice Tai Chi, we want body can be open and relaxing. Then our chi sinking down. Start now, we don't hold your chi at the chest. We're gonna sinking down the chi, start at the lower abdomen. So close your eyes. Do spend half a minute, okay? We do some abdominal breathing. Basically, tuck in your chin, relaxing your mouth. You can close your eyes and tuck in the chest slightly. Feel your chest, the lungs, this area open and smooth. Then sink, mindful, store your energy at our core area, lower abdomen, 丹田之处. Okay, relax your arm and shoulder. Relax the knee. Do not need to squat down a lot, but I do want you to relax in the knee. Don't standing straight, very stiff. Now at this moment, I want you to feel your weight, your root going down to the center of your feet, the bubbling well area, which is Yongquan Xue. At the same time, your center of your head, Bai Hui, lifted. Now your spine got open space, then your shoulder blade got opening. 后背撑开, 啊, 前胸放松, relax. Okay, inhale through your nose. Exhale, you can go through the mouth or nose, up to you. So everybody can do this. In the morning, at evening, or noontime, anytime when you feel you need to get some relaxing for your body and the mind, then you can do this. All right, open. Okay, so before we do the introduce our Tai Chi Ba Fa Wu Bu, then I want to give a little bit of stance practice. So earlier we are doing this parallel standing, just by natural standing. So now let's, everyone, please place your one of your foot back a little bit. Don't go too far. So we want to train some moving weight, forward and backward energy. Okay, this in Tai Chi, in Ba Fa Wu Bu, when we ready to learn the stepping forward, backward, we always need to train this stance, moving forward, backward, left and right, and neutral. Okay, so now from your weight at the center, hands pressed on the back, in the palms down, then we want to move back slightly. Then your front leg, look at my knee, don't be straight. Suspend slightly, then your back leg, open the hip about 30 to 45 degrees open, and your weight will be on the back leg more. Then we want to try to use your back leg to energize and push your weight forward. Arms follow. Now your weight move to the front leg. Then your front foot rooted down and back leg slightly straight, but not completely straight. Then use your front foot to energize on the ground to push your weight back. Very simple, see? This is called moving forward and backward. Forward. Your arms don't need to do much. Just follow your body's energy. Move. Forward. We also can coordinate with the breathing. When you're back, you do inhale, feel the absorb energy. Inhale. Then exhale. Then inhale. Exhale. Very, very nice. One more time. Backward. Keep your body neutral, upright. Forward. Okay, stand up. All right, shake your leg. If the first time, you might already feel, oh, my leg a little bit sore. That's very normal. Don't go too low. The stance don't go too low. Don't be too big. Okay, let me turn around to side view. We'll do, okay. So just make a very small stance and start with weight at the center. Then you will go back, see? So I want you to see the body remain upright. So do not go forward and backward moving your body, okay? You only try to focus with moving weight through your leg base. Upper body just quietly follow, go with your weight. Mm-hmm. So from here, you go forward from your back leg, push and front leg, bend. Then at the end, see this leg almost straight, but not completely straight. Then this toe is about 45 degrees open. Then hip is slightly open. Okay, so then when you move back, make sure your head, your body, keep neutral. Use your front leg to push. Back leg, receive. Then when you go forward, back leg, push, and the front leg, receive. That's very simple exercise, but it's very important that you are able to use later on in the Bafa Wubu form and the 24 form. Any Tai Chi form, you will need this weight shifting, yin and yang, transmit. Distinguish, yeah, back. Forward. See? And back. Very nice. Okay, now let's turn forward and relax. Shake it out. I hope you feel all right. Then now we try to place your step to the side position like a horse stance. Okay, so horse stance. Toes can open about 10 to 15 degree and relax your hip. Everyone, find your hip. Don't be tense. Drop, open, and relax. Great. Then pick up a ball. Simply pick up a ball. 沉肩坠肘, elbows relax, shoulders sinking down, hugging our tree trunk or a big ball. Okay, something natural you can breathe on. How from center, stay here for 5 seconds. This is a neutral energy. Feel the world of energy all over from your body. Forward, backward, left and right. Lifted from top, plummeting down. Okay, all the different direction. Then we can learn to shifting the weight to the side. So from center, we move to right side now. 60% and 40% different. At this moment, please pay attention on your feet. Sometimes when we do the side shifting, I know students tend to flipping their foot. So turn out, that's not right. So you want to try to still make your feet flat on the floor, and the center of your foot can suspend, not the big toe, not your little toe, okay? So right, left. So at this moment, I want you to pay attention here, the hip and the shoulder. So you don't want to move the hip. Those are common mistakes. You only want to rely on the muscles on your quad, on your quadricep. So you don't want to move in the hip. You don't want to move the shoulder. See, shoulders quiet and the hips stable. Then from center, shift. Very simple, right? Everyone can do it. You can start with a few times, and later maybe 10 times, 10, 20 times. Keep your knee open towards your toe and keep your back straight, upright. So don't lean forward, don't go backward, neutral. Back to center. Then we can close. Just make smaller your step and relax your hands. Close the four. Okay. All right, shake again. So now I will start move on to introduce the Ba Fa Wu Bu. So Ba Fa Wu Bu, Ba Fa means eight energy. The eight energy includes word of row, press, push, grab, split, and elbow strike, shoulder strike. In Chinese, Peng, Lü, Ji, An, Cai, Li, Zhou, Kao. This is our Tai Chi Quan's Ba Fa. Okay, the Wu Bu. Wu Bu means five steps. The steps will be five, we can say directions, forward, backward, left side, right side, and the neutral in the center. It is called five moving steps. We always need to use those steps in Tai Chi, which is I just trained you a little bit with stationary moving those divisions. But we have an actual moving steps, by moving the weight. 那么就是我们的五步，也是说太极拳里边的向前的进步、退步、左右的横开步、侧方向，还有中定。中定 means center, neutral. Okay, so five steps and eight energy put together, that's called 13 essential Tai Chi elements. So this 13 elements is really, really important. Just like when we learn the language, right? We need to learn all those letters, the sign words. That's right. They are letters and the sign words for the Tai Chi. If anyone don't know the Ba Fa and the Wu Bu, then very hard to learn Tai Chi. That's why we try to use this class to give you some general introduction. Of course, any this energy will take long time to get you to really able to find the detail to get to the handle very well. But we just try to give you some general ideas, then helps, hopefully it will helps you for learning more in the future. Okay, I think we can turn on the music and I will leading you just a few, hold on yet. I will leading you to you enjoy practice with me. I cannot do the everything together. I want to make you easy to follow. We will do piece, separate to several sections. I pick the certain movement that are very important and everyone can do. For example, stationary form. Then I will teach you the moving steps separately. Then, yeah, that way, by end of this class, you really can learn something. You maybe can practice by your own. Okay, so we will do the stationary parts, the eight energy. 原地不动的八法, 请大家先跟我一起做一遍, all right? So please enjoy practice this stationary forms with 八法, eight energy first. All right, so now we can start the music and standing with ready position. Wu Qi state. 声音有点大了，再小一点点。 OK. 。OK，begin，open your step left foot. Just about your shoulders width. Don't go too wide. Rise, get to the shoulders level and press down, sitting down. This is the opening. Ward off. Roll. Press. Push. Grab. Split. Elbow stretch. Shoulder stretch. Same form, try the other side. Palm. Li. Ji. An. Cai. Li. Zhou. Kao. Okay. Let's close. Okay, relax. So that's the forward view. Okay. So in order to help you to follow easier, I will do side view and I will do back view. So let's do the second time with side view. And again, when I do the front view, you can do mirror image with me if it's easier for you to follow. Okay, so try again. This time I will do side view. Ready position. Open your left foot. Raise your arm. Rotate and float. Then press down, sitting down. Feel like you are sitting on a high stool, very comfortable and relaxed. Landing your weight on your leg, relaxing on your back. Okay, and the hands press something down. Then we turn right, carry a ball. Ward off with your left arm forward. Right hand just press down here. Then we turn both arms, slightly rotate, roll up. Roll back down. Just turn about 90 degrees and close. Look at my hand, right palm press on your left wrist. Then press together. Right hand brush over. Roll both hands down. And push. 好,音乐停一下。音乐可以停一下。好, from here, grab. Now we from hand form, from palm, grab, make a fist. Grabbing down, turn your body. Then we do split, open the palm, split. So right palm is upward, left palm is outward. Okay, very slowly. Then your left arm bend, use your elbow to strike forward. This is called elbow strike. Yeah, make sure don't send in your shoulder. Just put the mind energy on the elbow. Yeah, remain your stance. Then lower your right hand, left palm block by your right shoulder. Right hand also grab the fist. This is called shoulder strike. Shoulder strike means you put the energy mindful at the shoulder area. Don't use the elbow. Okay, so shoulder strike. Feel the connection with your hip. That's to give you better energy on the shoulder strike. So after this side, then we will turn to left, carry a ball. So I might need to turn this side. So now we're on the left side. Carry the ball. So we will do ward off with left arm, okay? With the right arm and the left hand next to the hip. Same form, we always do duplicate it, do both sides. Pong, 然后慢慢的向前向上翻掌, rolling up and rolling down. Roll down and back. Now slowly turn your body. Left hand press on your right wrist. Then both hands in front of your chest. Press. When we do the press, don't send your body forward. Okay? Neutralize your body energy. Only press from your back. And out. And open, brush, then roll back, push. This is called push, 按掌, push forward. Okay, now after this, we will rotate, grab your fist, grabbing down to left and open. Split forward and right. Then your right elbow strike, right elbow strike. Turn your body a little bit. Don't twist in your hip. Don't twist in the knee. Okay. Then switch your hand. Left shoulder strike. Shoulder strike. This hand is fist, natural, grab the fist and use the shoulder area to feel the striking energy. All right, and finish. Okay, this is the stationary 八法. Okay, I hope you enjoy follow me. Then I will turn around, face back. Then you can follow me with a back view. All right, she shake it out. Very good. After that, I will introduce you some stepping, moving, 5 steps. 好, I will need the music. So let's just enjoy. I will try to do slow. Okay, I'll do slowly. Hope you can follow. Ready position. Begin. Mindfulness and relax your body. Opening. Settle down. 起势. 心静体松. Okay, turn right. Ward off. Roll. Press. Push. Grab. Split. Elbow strike. Shoulder strike. Turn left. Palm. Li. Ji. An. Tai. Lie. Zhou. Kao. Close. Tian. Beautiful. Okay, shake it out. All right, so that's the first part of the Ba Fa, which is 8 energy. Then of course, this 8 energy, we start learning with stationary, that way you have all your mind can focus with learning hand form. Then eventually I need to teach you the stepping. Then we will walk with steps, wu bu, 5 steps. Then to do the combination, the compose, the and also more former major movements of Tai Chi. That's all the form you will see from different forms. Okay, so now I will spend some time to introduce Wu Bu. Hopefully, I will able to do forward, back, left, and right, all the steppings. Then we may not have time to put all together with the hands, because you know all these 13 elements supposed to take long time, a lot of time to able to learn everything. That's why I only can do what I can make in today's demonstration, then give you all the information that I can offer. In the future, you can follow our other classes. I will teach the detail step-by-step class for online streaming class too. Then every class will only teach a couple of form, one or two movements. So that gives you a good study, can learn everything. But anyway, we try to learn some stepping right now. Very simple. So remember, I taught you to do this forward, backward in the beginning when we do the warm up. So now we will use this skill. So from here, everyone. So when we, after the beginning, opening form, so we just relax your hands. Don't do the hand form now. So relax, either your hands just relax next to your leg, that's fine. Or if you want to put behind your body, as long as you feel relaxed. So first, we need to learn pivot. So that's called pivoting. So pivot, turn your foot, right foot out, about 45 degree. Then two, we do a T stance. That's called T stance. You can do mirror image with me when I face to you, okay? And the three, give a small step with the heel on the floor. And don't be too narrow, don't be too wide, just about 1 or 2 feet in between your heel, this width, okay? Then four, you will lay down your front foot, move the weight from back leg, use the energy we just learned earlier to make a bow stance. See, that's called bow stance. Then from there, we will learn how to walk forward, 向前的行进, 这是我们五步里面的第一步, forward. 5 steps, we need to learn forward, backward, left and right and neutral, okay? So forward, one, move your front foot open, two, bring your back foot close as a T stance, three, small step forward, and four, make a bow stance. See, that's, now we walked forward, that's called step forward, 向前的行进,进步, okay? So let me turn back, follow me again from here. Lower your weight, one, pivot, two, T stance. So now your chest is about 30 to 45 degrees on the right side. Three, four, first step forward, bow stance, then continue, move forward. Then you want to shift your weight slightly back. Don't move fully back, but slightly back. And turn left. Two, bring your back foot close as a T stance. Three, step forward. Four, bow stance. All right, so that's stepping forward. We usually can do our hand form with ward off, step forward, with brush, knee, and push, step forward, with many, many hand form. Punch and block, push, and strike the fist, and many movement, step forward, okay? So now let's do the backward. After step forward, then we need to learn how to step back. Okay, so when we step back, you either can relax your hands or you can just put your hands on your abdomen. Remember, every time you need to move your weight back, you want to energize front foot. That's what we just prepared in the beginning, okay? So feel that, shifting your weight back, then empty, pick up the toe, then you can lift, take a small step, back, and you want to, when you take, I want to turn back view, side view for you to see. So when you take a step back, you want to make sure it's toe, we say toe, 或者说脚前掌着地。So don't try. When we go forward, always use heel. But when you go backward, always use toe. That's by natural common sense. Okay? And don't be too twisted, too narrow, and don't go too far. Just natural space. Okay? So I can also do again from here. Back, lift, then step back, small step, don't be too narrow, and sit on the back leg, push the front foot, twist and straight the front foot. See the front foot straight, then your back leg about natural open. Then one, two. Three, step back and shifting your weight, push your front foot and sit back. At the end, you want your weight on the back leg. When you're moving forward, walking forward, at the end, your weight landed 70% to the front leg. But when you're going back, then at the end, your weight want to be landed to the back leg. But both, no matter forward or backward, see the front foot cannot be open. Front foot has to be straight forward. So you don't want to do this. At the end, the front foot, if it leave open, that's not correct. That's not good for your knee. That's not the correct position. You want to straight, always forward. Okay, so that's two step now, forward and backward. Shake your leg, very nice. Then let's learn some step to side, left, and right. Okay, when we do the sidewalk, left and right, we also have open step with toe. Sometimes we open step with toe, and sometimes we open step with heel. That depends on what movement. Now, usually, when we're doing something continuously moving to the side, often we use the toe to open the step. So you don't want to do the heel step for sidewalk, and if you continue move, that's not correct. Okay, that's awkward, right? So you want to do, if you're continuous moving to the side, then you want to use toe. Just open the step naturally wide. Okay, don't stretch too far, and you are shifting the weight, pass through from this side to center. Then move your weight to the other side and close the step. Then you can do another step. Open and shift, then close. See? Very simple. That's how to move to the side. The same thing, we can move to this side. Open from left, pass through center to right. And empty left foot, close. Then step down left foot, empty your right foot, and open and close. Very good. Okay, that's the stepping left and right on the sides. Then when we use a heel, so, for example, sometimes when we have some opening, I mean, side step with a continuous move, but following step will be an ending with a stance. Then we will take a step with heel because next we will ending with a stance, right? Either bow stance or follow step or T stance, any stance. So you can have a first side with continuous step, and you can have another step with ending with a stance. This is also a stance. Okay, so that's why. So different way, you just need to be clear. Depends on your hand form. There's so much to learn, all right? That's about the side. Then what about neutral? Neutral is 中定. 中定 is everywhere. It's including forward, backward, including when you're shifting to the side. And also, we shows at the standing on one leg sometimes. We call 中定. One leg even can standing neutral. Or you parallel stance. That's also could be 中定, the neutral stance. Okay. So is someone asking about each step on pinyin? So we do have each step on pinyin. Okay. Sorry, I know we got some question. I don't know how you got a question. We have comments. Anyway, but for pinyin version, in the way when I teach our regular classes, then I usually can offer. We have English version, Chinese version, and the pinyin version for the each movement. But for this virtual class, I don't know how I'm gonna write a pinyin for you. Maybe if you have chance to check out our Zoom classes, then I will try to offer provide those information. Okay, definitely we can do that. Anyway, I was talking about the excuse me, the neutral stance, the neutral stepping. So after we know how to move in different direction, we always know how to neutralize at the center, no matter with both feet standing or with one leg standing. So you're scattering all the energy close to the dantian and separate from up lifting, down rooting, and left and right opening and all closing. So that's called neutral energy. Okay, in Tai Chi form, we have golden rooster standing on one leg, and we have this cross hands at the center. Then even though we do this just Huan Yuan Zhan Zhuang, holding the ball, standing there quietly without any move, those all can contain the neutral energy. 中定, 就是咱们的 step 步子向。中间合拢，all coming from both everywhere direction. Then same thing from center, we go out, ward off，叫膨进，八方的膨进，ward off to everywhere and comes in to the center. So that's 开与合的关系，也就是我们的 really essential idea principle of Tai Chi, opening and close. 叫开合，Yin and Yang. All right, I think time flies, and I only able to introduce you that much of Ba Fa Wu Bu today. Again, we have many different classes to specifically teach form, to teach each form, each energy, and all this lot of training for the stepping. So we just finished a session of the Ba Fa Wu Bu from our summer online classes. And this fourth session from, I believe it's 2 weeks later, end of September, we have another four new session. I will teach the Ba Fa Wu Bu. If you'd like to continue learning, definitely contact us to check out our new classes. But now, last few minutes, I want to introduce little bit about the Yang style Tai Chi 24 form. So because those two forms are all very, very popular, I have so many students asking, what's the difference for the beginner? Which form I should learn first? You know, depends. Both 24 form and Ba Fa Wu Bu, they are very good Tai Chi form for beginner. And for 24 form, I would say it's a former Tai Chi routine. It's a Tai Chi form. It need a little bit more space. You might want to go because you will move forward, backward, and take about 6 minutes to complete one set of practice, and usually take at least 12 weeks to 15 weeks to learn this whole set. 12 weeks, yeah, 3 to 4 months to learn this whole set. Then for Ba Fa Wu Bu, it's very unique. It's for everyone. If you don't have a big space, you're only at your office, even though your bedroom. So only few steps moving, small space, then you can do everywhere. And it's short. It's only take about around 3 minutes. You can do one set practice. They both are good, but it just depends if you want to a former Tai Chi form, contains all major stance, kicking forms, and more movements or beyond 24. Okay. Because in the Yang style 24 form, we have all the major movements from traditional Yang style Tai Chi, not only the elements. Then for this Ba Fa Wu Bu, we can't cover so many Tai Chi form. We only cover the Tai Chi elements. That's why they both important. If you have to choose, if you're able to, I think you can learn. If you never learned Tai Chi before, you can learn Ba Fa Wu Bu first. Then you learn Yang style Tai Chi 24 form. Then we also have another class called Fundamental of Tai Chi. Then you can do that is similar with Ba Fa Wu Bu. Basically, you need to learn all the fundamental movements, elements, and essential skills to prepare. Then you can get to learn the Yang style 24 form, entire former Tai Chi form at the end. Okay, so I think hopefully I give you this explanation, you understand what different between Yang style Tai Chi 24 and the Ba Fa Wu Bu Tai Chi. Last few minutes, let's see. I want to maybe I will take you, I'll give you a demo for a little bit, first half of the Yang style 24 form. That way, you know what is different, okay, of the 24 form. It's a Tai Chi routine, actually. So please, if you already know the form, you can follow me. If you haven't learned yet, then you just enjoy watch. Then you can follow whatever you can follow. I will just only demo half of the Tai Chi because the second half is a little bit more complicated if you are very beginner. So I don't want to give you a hard time. We just pick the simple part. I will move a little bit because we need some space. Here we go, begin. Thank you. All right, I will finish it here. Hope you have enjoyed the practice with me. See, this 24 form is already contains the stepping, moving forward, backward, and also side moving, both left and right. And we contains a lot of hand form, eight energy as well. That's why they are all combination. So these two items are related, okay? Again, Ba Fa Wu Bu and 24 form, they're really related. You want to walk together, then that's the best combination. All right, I think we should do some cooling down now. Everyone, please relax, chop chop your leg, and just relax, give you some cooling down. If you're first time, try Tai Chi. I hope you did not work too hard today. Then if you're already a Tai Chi Tai Chi friends, then I hope you enjoyed this instruction. Again, so specifically during this pandemic time, I really hope everyone doing all right, keeping health, keep healthy, and do everything that good for your health and wellness. I will continue offer more program and Tai Chi classes. If you like our program, please subscribe our channel and you can like it. And also you please notify, send the notification. Yeah, I will give you some sign. All right, so that's what, if you want to support me, and you're welcome to do that, and I will continue to support you if you like to learn in Tai Chi. Okay, so welcome to contact us. So we check our website, and we have the class, new class information on our website, and also I believe on this YouTube description underneath. Then check it out and contact us. From Facebook or website or anything. All right. Thank you, everyone. And hope to see you again next time. Thank you.